evening, everyone, and welcome once again to our continuing live coverage from the 2016 Canadian Mixed Doubles Curling Championship. We're live at the Nutana Curling Club in Saskatoon. My name is Sean Joyce. Susan Lang with me at our broadcast table.
Good evening, curling fans, and welcome.
And Carrie Tarasoff running the cameras and all the control panels to my left. Well, we're down to everybody's got two games left, four round robin draws, but everybody's got two round robin games left. We're going to feature the game tonight between Lisa Weigel and John Epping, and they will be playing the father daughter duel, Jaylen Cotter with her dad, Jim. This is a critical game for both of these teams. Weigel and Epping come in at a record of 4-1, and the Cotters, representing British Columbia, come in with a record of 3-2. We've been talking all for the last couple of days about where that cut line is going to be as far as whether or not it's going to be tiebreakers. 12 playoff spots up for grabs. The first place team in each of the pools gets in automatically to the quarterfinals. 8 other spots more or less up for grabs. And right now, 18 teams sitting at 2 losses or better. There's another 5 teams at 3 losses, hoping that some of those teams are going to fall back to them. And 6 of those, out of the 18 teams, 9 of them are 3-2, and 6 of those 3-2 teams are on the ice tonight.
Trying to simplify what Sean was just going through there, I came at it the other way.
We started with
32 teams. We do know 12 will make the playoffs here, so I was asking Sean to look up who has 4 and 5 losses, because that will certainly preclude you from moving on to Sunday's play. So we were at 13 teams.
13 teams at 4 losses or more, which certainly mathematically doesn't look like there's any chance to make 12 out of the 32. You think you'd have to have a winning record.
Was it that high at 13 or 9? No, 13.
It was 13, yeah.
Yeah. So that was just trying to simplify things a little bit the other way. So we have not yet had a chance to see this Lisa Weigel John Epping combination sitting nicely with a 4-1 record. Both of these curlers, of course, very well known on the circuit. Their opposition, Jim Cotter, also again a very well known curler, very well respected curler, playing with his, I believe, Jaylen is 16 years old. They're at 3-2 and playing strongly.
Well, we've got everybody in Pool A and Pool B plays in this draw. Pool C and Pool D play in the next draw. And then everybody has their final round robin game tomorrow morning. We should have a bit better of an idea after the two draws tonight as to whether or not 2 or 3 losses is going to be that cut line. There's, as we said, there's a number, all those teams at 3 losses.
Well, already as
need a little help.
Players were coming out of there. Warm-up rooms and everything here at the Nutana. They've got great big draw boards, and believe me, they're all looking at the combinations and checking who's all still around and who needs to beat who.
So when we do the updates at the fourth end break, we'll try to give you a bit of detail as to who's in which pool. And keep an eye on all these two-loss teams.
Good.
So very nice opening draw there by Jaylen.
Like same way or
back
way?
On sheet 4, this is what? I think her third way? Game in a row, and we
ideal
see
turn, yeah.
A little under curl there, these. But nice okay. Weight. Yeah. Sits on the corner of that stone.
Middle. Been out there for a long time.
I think you're middle, yeah.
Good weight. Perfect weight. Besides simply a little straighter. It's perfect weight.
A little tighter for
line? A little tight.
Yep. So the one game that this Epping Weigel team has lost was to Saskatchewan Stephanie Lawton and Steve Laycock, but Steph and Steve have had a rough go at things, so they're
right,
going to be
down
in tough to make the playoffs.
And comes down to the inside of that yellow stone, sits right on the button.
So where do you take? Like middle eight?
Nice sweep.
Just not draw the button, it's a little slower.
A little slower.
Not
much. Well, I just got on an inside path.
Yep, a little bit.
But you were still able to drag it.
Okay, whoa. Is it heavy? Whoa. heavy.
What a fabulous learning experience for Miss Cotter, learning from one of the best in the business.
Good. A nice draw down to the corner, taps it a bit, but keeps a good angle on that yellow.
Yeah.
Watching John Epping this year on TV and his WCT Tour events, I certainly think he's been one of the most exciting players that we've seen. The shots that he pulls off and pulls off consistently certainly understates how his team has gone up the rankings here on the CTRS system. It's just such a pure shot maker.
Oh, the outside of this one trying to get some extra curl. Lots of room by the guard. Already we're seeing that one side just a little bit straighter.
Yeah. Same thing. Okay. Just draw on it.
Third rock down.
That's been consistent.
We can tap it an inch.
Pretty much all weekend.
Better there now, eh?
Oh yeah, that's
right up his feet.
And the curlers actually do share some information amongst themselves. I know everybody was sort of behind the sheets here. You know, we're nice close quarters. It's a nice way to meet these curlers. And they were all chit-chatting about, oh, I'm just going on the sheet you came off of. You know, anything you mind, you know, tell me, anything you can care to share? Any rock information?
I think part of that comes from the fact that they're not all in the same pool.
Wait's good.
Line's good.
How's line? How's line?
Some of them have to get along a little bit as well.
Need to curl?
Away from here this week. They're back on the same team next week.
Heavy.
That's right. We still yet haven't had a matchup where we've had teammate against teammate. I'm looking forward to that one. Might have to wait for the playoffs, but.
All right, not bad.
Doesn't get the line to get onto his own. Wiggles through there and may not be a bit of a bad spot for that stone.
Try and hit that and move that.
Okay.
So how do you try and do this?
Yeah.
I think that's safer, because even if I nose this, all the red, these yellows go, right? I should fly a bit,
yeah let's
that.
Do that.
Yeah.
Okay, you hear the conversation there, and John can throw these as hard as anyone, and from that camera angle, you can see he's got room on the inside of the stone he's trying to hit first, so maybe he'll get all three yellows out. He will lose one of the reds. I think maybe just one, though.
Curl!
He's going to want this to curl a bit. He's got a lot of room by the guard. Would have liked to come by it tight. Does get the two moving, and that one will spin.
Good.
If it's not all the way out the back, it's back far enough that it shouldn't factor in.
There, kind of roll right in front of that one, okay?
Okay.
So you want to get to the inside a little bit.
Okay.
Almost the same weight.
Same way, okay.
So wearing the BC jackets as they came out of British Columbia as their mixed doubles champions.
And the key here for Jim wants to get across the face enough to just roll over and...
What's he playing?
He wants to angle the two yellows onto that red.
Chap on top.
Okay.
And then I'll play off on red. And try and make the double on there. Kick it sideways.
You can hear John and Lisa talking about what they're going to play next. And I think, you know, we've seen a couple of teams get tight for time. We saw in the last draw the Quebec team getting, I would call it ridiculously tight on time. 14 seconds left with two rocks to throw.
Fortunately, they had those two timeouts in their back pocket, but that's still pretty strenuous and adding to a lot of strain.
Yep.
There must have been a few rush shots earlier on before they called those timeouts that,
anyway,
mind you, they still hung on to win that game.
The point I was about to make is that's part of the key. You hear John and Lisa, they're already anticipating what shot's going to be made, and they know what they're going to play if it is. Now, it wasn't made, so that's changed things for them. They have to discuss now.
Just try and whisker just into here.
A little bit.
Just kind of bump that a bit. Like, give yourself some angle.
Yeah.
And did I pull it out when I was sweeping it?
Jim just trying to figure out what happened with that stone. Actually, I think his result's really good.
I don't think it's the worst.
Yeah. Well, how do you ever get both of those yellows out to try to bring any of those reds back into count.
Yeah, this side's real fast. I barely let that go.
And John, for his big weight capabilities and ability to read angles, has a really nice touch too. Seen him make a lot of really
skinny
big
the
draws.
Guard. Whoa,
sound like Ed Sullivan, really, really big.
Sorry.
You know, that came off kind of funny. I'm not so sure that they didn't actually touch the yellow one on the edge of the forefoot first.
Oh, it's mine.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Just up here.
Okay. We do see that quite a bit where one player needs to remind their teammate whose turn it is to be in the hack.
Well, that yellow shot stone sitting in between the two reds. Looks pretty safe right now. Probably the only way you could get it out would be to try to skinny pick it from the intern side.
It's light. It's down. Line's good though.
It's heavy.
Line's good.
Let's tap ours a bit. No, weight's not bad.
Looking to sit another one in the pocket here.
Pretty good.
Well, made the shot they called.
Sorry, it's really.
I'm not sure it does anything to address what they're going to play here.
Actually, you know what? You can't. You can't, because the guard's in the way.
What they were wondering about is that they could hurt themselves, and John went out to take a look and doesn't feel she could hit the red one to hurt herself.
Yeah, you're perfect. Peel. Use the.
You want me to pick it?
Yeah, pick it. Peel. You know where your broom is? You want to take this much outside the rock.
Yeah, you think it'll curl that much?
What do you think? It's fresh here. We just got to hit it. We got to hit a millimeter of it.
Okay.
You can't hit a quarter of it, right? You got to hit a millimeter.
Okay.
What do you think?
Oh, we saw Jesse Kaufman earlier today make this shot.
Okay.
We did.
Yeah.
Good with that?
Yeah, I'm good with that.
Okay.
And to win the game.
You got this. Let's go.
This one's with a chance to score two.
Byron
does pick it back, gets a little rub on the yellow or on the red, but looks to have stayed enough to get two. We'll just wait for the callers to confirm, and yes, it is. It's 2 points. Great shot by Lisa Weigel. That's not a shot a lead plays very often.
No, that's for sure. But
this might be the first time in her life.
You going for Joe?
Well, you certainly know with that team, they're practicing all the shots. You never know who you might have to replace someday if somebody's ill or not able to make a game, but. Certainly for a person who's known for her lightweight ticks, that is an outstanding shot.
That was exactly the comment, well, a little bit more tongue-in-cheek, that you heard Jim Cotter make. Asked her if she was going for Joanne's job.
That was real good, Ann. Take that. Twos are like getting
it'll curl nice, eh? And it's
this
right up
curl.
To
yeah, it's right up
right to up speed. You can drag it a bit, but...
Yeah, right up to
there's Jim Cotter sort of reiterating what we've been saying, too, about how it's so,
show me again.
With the rules, easy to generate a lot of multi-point ands. So he's saying to Jaylen, don't worry about it. Twos are like just giving up one.
But, you know, I think if they had taken a second to look at that and realized that pick was the only shot she had, they could have taken that away and they steal that end.
Oh, it's picking. I just picked.
Yeah.
little heavy.
Heard the comment there from John. Takes a bit of a pick. And curls past the guard. Still keeps a corner in front of the yellow.
It'll be quick here then.
Good shot.
Same as your draw. Weight's good.
Needs to curl.
Stay your side. Yeah, she's okay if her weight's good. Like, this line's okay if her weight's good.
Yep.
If her weight's
needs
a little
to
heavy,
curl.
Then stop it.
15.
Good.
Nice sweep judge by
Jim.
Very nice shot by Jim.
Great weight, too. Puts that right on the face of the red, and that little 2-inch bump is enough.
Thank
you. You get a good look at it from this angle. She's freed up that red to go by the yellow.
That's perfect. Good shot.
Thank you.
John Epping now looking to come down and break the existing freeze. He'd like to get to the inside.
I got a curl. Is it
on.
Heavy?
No, weight's great.
Want
weight's
to go?
Great. Yeah, go ahead. Whoa.
Wants to get just to the inside. Yeah, he'd like to keep the red a piece in front of that yellow.
Okay.
That worked out very well.
Sorry, John.
Okay. Rolls over enough to be shot rock. Not quite as much in front of the yellow as they would have liked, but I think that's a pretty good spot. Real tough to get that red out. You can just maybe see a sliver of the edge.
On there. If we chip the guard, it's not bad. Play tight to that guard, a little straighter in this spot. Or a corner freeze on theirs.
Okay, sounds good.
Doesn't sound like we're going to have any troubles this time figuring out what teams are playing. We've had a few teams out here that, of course, they know each other very well and don't have to say a lot. We don't always know what they're looking at.
Well, Jim's in as much of a coaching role out here tonight as much of a player teammate, which certainly helps us.
This is our first chance to get a direct look at them, but I have seen them a few times looking to the side. And one thing I've noticed is that they're one of the teams that does more two-player sweeping than any of the rest. Whereas a lot of teams will rely on one person and then they'll switch sides. The Cotters tend to get both people sweeping, and they will decide which side they need to go from. But
I'm feeling this outturn is going to be a little heavier.
Well, Jay Lynn, as a teenager, is not a hefty build. Built girl, she doesn't still has some developing to do with muscles and everything, so needing her teammate there to come out and help with the sweep, I think, is a big part of it. Her sweeping is coming along very well, but
knows it. Get rid of that.
Still a young
girl.
Get rid
of the one yellow. Intern.
John had been in the hacks, had to come down and take a look. I think what he wanted to see for sure was who was shot and what the angles looked like. Maybe he wanted separation as well. And the guard does belong to them. He's going to look to run this straight back. This is a little outside the line he wanted. And with that kind of weight, you can want it to curl all you'd like. It's just not going to cooperate.
Well,
just peels the guard out.
Jim, earlier on his shot,
I think
it was
we
just
play
quite okay if they remove that guard and
roll
bumped
there.
It over. So I think
if
this
we
is
draw
going to
here,
help the Cotter team.
The triple's there, right?
Yeah.
And actually, that one might even come back onto here. So why don't we almost same way tap it, try and roll this one over here, and that might be our second point later, potentially our third, okay?
How much weight?
Be like back line.
Okay.
A little less.
So Jim holding the broom on this one. Jim will be jumping up to sweep it himself then.
I always really enjoy watching Jim Cotter curl also. He seems to be one of these players that can seem to win games all on his own.
Wait's good.
Whoa, whoa, clean.
Half a rock.
Needs to curl a bit.
Need to curl?
Should be good, yep.
Is it just a little thicker than half?
Yeah.
He certainly didn't get the spill over to the side that he wanted. Over,
but it's hard
middle,
to tell from
middle,
the camera
middle.
Angle.
Yeah, inside, middle, inside.
Whether
middle,
the triple okay. clears that red on the back red, back of the forefoot or not.
Well, with the speed that John's gone down to throw this, I don't think he's worried about any jams here.
Okay. He'd like to hit this right on the nose, stay right there. Maybe, if anything, a little bit center line side.
So we'll probably have like a hit and roll, or we can freeze on that one.
Okay. Yep, yep, yep.
Trying to get it to that center line side.
Doesn't clear the back one, and will have enough weight to spin out of the rings anyway. Looks like it's still in play, and so it's yellow at the back of the forefoot shot rock.
Draw here. Okay. Even there is not bad. They probably have that.
Surprised.
I don't mind here. Same draw. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Beginning. Just hook around that one a bit. It's good.
Okay.
Yeah.
John not getting up to the nose of that rock that set up this opportunity for the Cotters to sit to.
You know, I think he's got just enough room here that if he could probably touch his own, move it maybe 2 inches and kind of sit in the pocket. Right now there's enough of a stagger on those stones. If you corner froze the yellow and came down,
it's pretty good.
Yes.
Big weight, it probably goes over the top.
How's line?
Line's good, line's good. Just clean. Just clean. Yep. Yep.
Really starting to move
line's
now.
Good. Just for weight.
By the red.
Got that little hook that he was looking for.
Got a big hook, ends up just about lined up to his own.
Hit it this way for the double.
That's good.
You don't have much of it. This one definitely is there if you want to do that. Hair high. That's out, Agent.
No, it is. It's out.
That's still a good play. You made John come down and look again. That's going to cost him some time.
Right. It's up to you. It's out, or at least this way you make contact.
Where do I have to hit?
Yeah.
Jim Clotter's such a sinister person.
Millimeter high, 3/4. Millimeter high.
In between. Do you like to clean your path when you go down?
Okay.
And you can take the other pair if you want.
Can you show me the pencil?
Okay. Yep. Yeah.
Okay.
So they talked
about
not
a dead off. We got the intern draw.
The two possibilities for doubles. She could play
maybe
that, basically that same thin tick she played last time.
There?
Try to catch the top of the other Yellowstone. But there's some risk there that you don't make contact with anything.
Yeah, so
they're going to play the run back.
Two-thirds.
You're pretty much guaranteed to get rid of one of them here. I don't think there's any way you could hit this offline enough to miss the yellow and dead stick it on the red. I think one of the yellows has to go. Well, unless you fail to make contact at all, but she's pretty close here. Makes the hit, drives it back, just sticks the second one.
All right, kiddo. Same weight. It's fast. I'll come sweep it.
Okay.
It's just so interesting watching any of these Holman teammates. If you didn't look at the face or the body type, if you just keep your eye on the arm and the rock, they all throw identically. And that certainly makes it simpler for Rachel to put that broom down, but it's just phenomenal there. Very consistent technique, and that certainly every skip's dream is when you've got that same rock coming at you.
Jalen Cotter, 16-year-old, with a chance.
It's okay.
Draw for two here.
Might be up. Just for weight.
This is one of the more open draws that you get to play in this format. No guards or anything in the way, so it's all a matter of the weight. She's actually got line to the backing if she needs it.
Jalen throwing with the hair broom, then for sure cannot come in to help sweep. And
well, did touch that stone. Didn't get the line to really play the backing, but doesn't touch it back far enough to do herself any harm. Picks up her 2 points, and we're all tied up after two ends.
Just love that composure.
Yeah, you know, I'm really surprised. Yes, it was just a little bit strong, but with where the broom was put down, I'm sure she was thinking that she had the back 8. I thought she did too, really. She's only just back 8 with her weight. I'm surprised that didn't come across.
Oh, by the way,
sorry about that.
We've been red so much that
we heard that comment last game too.
Yeah, the rocks at this event are predetermined, so you're going to get a kind of a split of how many times you throw with each color, but that's not to say that if you go from red to yellow to red to yellow, you can have a string of games where you're playing with the same color. I think it was Brett Gallant that said earlier, we've been red so many times, because then he's turned around and said, I think I'd like to be red again the way it's going.
Thought she was inside a little bit, but she did get it back out to the broom, so Jim will probably be able to hold it out here.
Same side of the sheet she just played, and certainly this appeared to be pretty straight over here. We saw that in the first end as well.
My fault.
Do you want to throw the out here?
Just a sliver of an oversweep gets that little rub off, but still sitting a piece in front of the red.
I thought I was inside, and then I just like...
This fell out. I was trying
to get it out there
a bit.
I think it's still tight.
Yeah.
Your weight was good. I should have just left it.
It's okay.
Holding okay. Line's okay.
Good
really
shot,
set
though.
It.
Getting some curl
really
on this stone. Now this is the same stone that they felt picked earlier.
Which side?
To the top of the button.
Well, there's always been the one red stone that's caused the red team grief on this sheet, one that's sort of been a cutter. And at the start of the game, the teams get to figure out which are the two dead rocks, as you call them, the ones with the black ponytail holders, the markers for the preset shots.
Lots of room, too.
Yeah, they can throw all 8 stones in practice, but they have to pick which 5 they're going to play at the game. So
Yep.
In theory, if there is a cutter out there, there's no guarantee that it's been in play every game.
Come on, let's go.
What do you like? But we've certainly, anybody that's been red on sheet 4 has always struggled with one rock, but we can't quite see the numbers. And
or we can freeze there.
Yeah?
You were right. Thought we were there. It's not bad.
Okay, yeah. Here, John?
Well, John Epping was looking at the intern. What he could see on that outturn side, decided he'd like to come down to it that way.
Well, I thought he needed to go.
A little more.
This is the straighter turn. His first shot was to corner freeze his own at the top of the forefoot and try to line it onto that, line it up to go onto that stone at the back. But I think he decided he's got room. This is a straighter turn. Cooked this a little bit early. This is still hanging out, and it's got lots of weight.
Hard, at least. Bounce that hard. I think it would be this fast out there. I should have swept that earlier.
Yeah, touch more.
Oh, that was really late. Sorry.
It's okay.
Now you know. Pretty fast everywhere.
Looks like Jim's looking to follow that down, kind of sit on the face of those two.
Well, because we kind of were out there in practice.
Didn't hear a call. He could actually play this with maybe bumper weight, hit the red, try to roll in towards the middle and off the top of the yellow, up in for shot. Get in behind cover that way, but might be better or safer at this point in time to keep two stones behind this.
Line's good.
His weight's good.
Line's good.
To clean. It.
Yep, yep.
Just for line.
Line's good.
Small bump. Needs to curl.
Line's good. No, it's good.
Puts it right in the pocket. It is second shot, but without last rock, the key for the Cotters right now, first of all, you want
to
cut down the opportunity for the other team, and you'll worry about stealing later.
If I can ever tap, tap.
You're going to get the double.
Mm-hmm. Be awesome. Just the danger is if I roll here, we're not happy.
Okay.
But I think we got to try and move this to here.
Okay.
Needs to follow Jim down there.
We have played a double run now.
Very confident line call from Jay Lynn. No hesitation. She was very sure that they had the correct line, and they did.
They're throwing two so far.
Yes.
Actually, you know what? Force here is really good too, right? So if we force, we don't need to go too crazy. So that's out there a bit.
This is the shot that we've seen. It's given a lot of teams grief this. Trying to find that back 12-foot weight, match it to the broom line.
He's got to throw that couple of feet more weight because he's looking for the tap, and we already know this side's a little straighter.
But he is getting a nice curl
here.
In.
Sorry, Don.
Well, they made the tap. Didn't really clear, so that yellow in the middle still never leaving the rings. And I would tend to agree. I think it's one red right now. Not much Jim can do with those stones in the 4 foot, so he's going to look to corner freeze his own stone at the top of the 8 foot just to keep Epping and Weagle from being able to get down and play that tap again. And you hear it with both teams. It's interesting to catch the conversations this game. Both teams already talking about, well, we expect them to make this. This is what we're going to have to play. John Epping said if he makes this, wherever he puts this, we're probably going to have to run whatever he plays.
Okay, it's good. It's good.
It's been an interesting game to watch that way from the aspect that this is, we've seen all four players at the house end a lot more in this game than we probably have in any other game at all. Usually the one player's down by the hacks, if not both of them. We've had a couple of games where people realized, oh, maybe I should have been there to sweep that one out.
That's
that in that first five stones where a stone can't be removed, and they were already both down at the hack end.
Yeah.
Well, the big decision comes whether you want to have that target broom to aim at or not, having that person in the house to call the line.
Just runs it by everything. And, you know, for the Epping Weagle pairing, that the thing that might bother them about that more than anything else is that the red shooter didn't get that far off, so you can make this shot again. Everything will be staggered.
So that has been nice, this national championship here in Saskatoon. With the 32 teams, you certainly see a wide variety of ways to play, and I don't really think that there's any right way or wrong way. It's which way teams work together the best. Pros and cons to the various styles. You know, you've got somebody in the house holding the broom like what Jim is. Not only is it providing a solid target for your shooter, but you're still gathering information about the ice, watching the rock come in towards you.
It's down.
How's the line?
Whereas we've had a lot of players
Mine's good.
Playing their shots without a broom
to curl a bit,
look at. So you, you don't get that secondary feedback about if you hit your broom, did you float it out a little bit, that type of a thing. So there's a lot of guessing and uncertainty that goes on with this game.
Wanted to corner freezer on the top and ends up coming in and tapping that red. And now I think it's red sitting too.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. Is that me?
As long as you hit it, you're good.
No problem. It's all good.
If you have enough to come down and
it's fast.
Yeah. I'm not sure what you're looking at, John.
We're
already sitting two.
I don't think they can get more than two.
We are two, right?
We are two.
That would have been bad.
Let's play that draw. Yeah.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. So this spot's curling.
Yeah.
Okay.
That Yellowstone in the middle of everything. Well, it's only third shot. It's never leaving the forefoot.
All right.
So Lisa Weigel going to try to draw, the intern draw.
Well,
you
can.
You're not going to hurt me. Just throw T-line weight.
No.
Just take care. It'll carve hard at the end.
I disagree with that one. John's saying she can't. She can touch her own without hurting it, but if she touches the one at the top of the forefoot, it goes sideways into the other one and moves it back out into the third position.
You
need to throw this just dead to the tee line and hope you get enough finish at the end to grab enough forefoot for the third point.
That side's probably way heavier.
Yeah. Tee line, tee line. We gotta tell me my line.
I don't. I think the line's pretty close.
It's real close. Now it does touch that red and.
Okay, sorry, John.
Not enough to move the second red. Just nudges it up
one
against
for
it.
Sure. Let's take a look at these. Pretty sure it's two. Yeah.
Again, that's where you lose that
two.
Person in the house that's judging that line. That required a really fine, well, it was such a small target area.
You know, Lisa jumped up thinking that they needed the second sweeper, perhaps the curl, and then they had nobody in position to even try to call line.
That's right. It's like when you're doing all that coaching, you're trying to tell that third who's holding the broom for the skip, stay in the house.
Not sure it would have mattered a whole lot. A little bit strong. It had to be dead on the tee line, and then that was going to slide through anyway. But, you know, if that curls another
much quicker than I
half inch, she might have nudged that second red stone over far enough not to get the second point.
Just by a couple years. A couple years.
Yeah.
Great weight. I just had to give you more.
All right, good end.
Sorry. You threw it great. You threw it
great. We're just a little behind on time. It's nothing to be
okay, so what do you
get
think?
Two back.
So you gotta take the air, right?
Patience.
Yeah.
So we know that side's fast.
So a lot of times on the four-player teams, when you're playing on the clock, one person is assigned responsibility of watching the clock. Wonder if maybe that's not Lisa's job on the regular team. She's the one watching it here already in the fourth end. Now there's a couple of the teams out there in this two-player event that we're not sure either one of them has been watching the clock.
Well, an end can get away from you so quickly, too. You play four ends, and you're doing pretty well on the clock, and then if you get a really complicated one,
like the intern?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then you're scrambling. The game where we've seen so many of the players where they make up the time is they're very speedy in the hack. They've got their pre-shot routines down to just a couple of seconds.
That's why I was kind of surprised.
Yep, hard line! Hard! Hard line! Hard!
You want to play?
That's fine.
Well, we can't really blame the two sides of the ice. We've seen two stones come up a little short here already to start the end, but one down either side.
Well, they talked about how much quicker that side of the sheet is, too, so looks like Jaylin just pulled a little bit off on that. Still, it's not in the absolute worst position.
No.
It's still better than being in the back 8-foot corner.
Well, it's a corner guard. It's your own color, and it's a little tighter to the ring than the center, so there's relatively simple angle slash onto that stone at the top of the rings right now.
Think good.
I think you got room.
It's running straight, so it's got to be heavy.
Me? Just leave it.
Oh, screw that.
This, yeah.
Jeez, John. slow.
Well, and that's not the first time we've seen that, too. And, of course, the two players...
All right, outturn, come around there.
...don't have a lot of feedback. They get what the other person threw, and as they play both sides...
I heard him say it's not
definitely
that
one
slow,
side's so not the same speed as the other.
I think because we've had a few
that's
here
been
now.
It's consistent all week, so...
It's probably sped up.
When they have to start guessing a little bit. One player comes up short.
The
next one adds
draw
a little too much weight.
Yep.
Still, I'm sure Jim got a good read off of John's shot there.
Go, 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 go. Yep. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Freeze that one. Yep.
Well, I'm not so sure he
yep
did.
Hard, 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 hard.
Want to try your shot again?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go, John.
Plan B there. That did... The weight came off that one in a hurry as well. Does set up a nice angle on the red. He's got an angle to get it by, but that relies on one more miss.
Run back. Gets rid of one of theirs. Like if he makes a real good one.
And this might be why we saw a couple of teams earlier in the event. They'd only play one side of the sheet, so the weight, they always knew what the weight would play. It'd be in-turn one turn one way, and they'd play the out-turn the other way, but they didn't have to adjust their weight that much. They knew the one side of the sheet was always going to be consistent
good
weight. The problem that created, and I can remember one game at least, they got to had to play the other side of the sheet later in the game, and nobody knew what the weight was. John manages to bring the weight down
off
a bit, but still heavy.
Nah, Shane Moore.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, even more.
What?
He's taking even more.
Yeah.
And you know, when you get a heavier side like this, and then we're still only in the fourth end, they're playing this side the whole end. They're going to sweep a lot of rocks down here. You might see them get this side polished up and get the speed up on this side, and then they've ignored the other side for long enough that it might frost up a little bit on them.
So opening up the broom, they saw how tight to the
top
rocks that John's rock came with that back eight weight. So
just for life,
Jim does have top eight weight. They want to make sure they
get the weight.
You're by. You're by.
We're by.
Yep.
This is sick.
You can come back on this time.
No. Sick.
Nice shot.
Well, Jim wanted to be in front of the tee line, just slips behind it.
So this is an opportunity that you don't normally get in a curling game. You've just had two draws, and now you get a third one. Only when you're sort of short one in a club game or something do you ever get this opportunity to throw three. So no pressure, John, but... Expecting the third one here to be excellent after having a heavy one.
Third time's the charm.
Mine's good. Just for weight. Mine's good. Yep.
Weight's
you're
perfect.
You're by.
Weight's perfect.
When he finds the weight, he gets the curl. Puts this stone right on the inside corner of that yellow and sits for shot rock.
Is it hair down there?
Yeah.
We gotta blast.
I got a 14.8 on his.
Wow. Right there.
So it's like, it's real quick there, right?
So it's even faster than though what I just threw. Like it's picking up every rock.
So Jim can see.
Nice throw.
Thin, let's call it a thin half of that stone, perhaps.
Yes, he can certainly see more than what Lisa could see on her pick there
like
in the first end. So
about like a 15.
Yeah.
Jim's
more than
world,
he
this is
the
more
shot
than
anyway
enough.
Gosh, it looks light, but it's.
It'll be interesting to see what happens with the yellow coming back. You know those two rocks, when they're that close together, it's going to drag, but there's not a lot of distance between the yellow and the red behind it. I don't know if he can drag that enough to spin that yellow towards the center line side a couple of inches.
Jim, with the lift delivery, can throw the big weight as well as anyone in the game.
This is going to be tight. It rubs the yellow.
No, that's okay. I thought he was getting by.
It's okay.
You couldn't even hear that tick.
Well, that's only because Jim went, ah, as it ticked.
But that kind of weight and only move that rock over a foot.
Don't you think?
Yeah.
Shows you how thin that redirect was.
We'll throw top eight. Throw top 12, top eight. And all three things.
I'll tell you what. So what they put this rock in the spot that they're looking for. We might get a chance to find out how hard a 16-year-old can throw. Because I'm looking at the angle on that red, yellow, red run back. That could kill all three reds.
We'll take right there, okay?
Okay.
If she can throw it hard enough.
Right there?
Yep.
It's as fast as we see.
Give it to you. Copy.
Yeah. Well, we had it. Okay, we got this intern tap to the button.
So Jim, not looking at your.
Doesn't sound like.
Dazzler there.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you see it?
Yeah, I do. Yep. Yep. Line.
Line only. Really line only.
Tap off.
You not by?
We're real close. Go, go, go.
Well, it hardly matters now. That's in a position that would block that shot.
Sorry.
Don't know for sure if it was there. It's just.
I can't see.
You know what's in the ballpark? We can't always get a true view of the angles from here.
Call line for like 7-8.
Nice feet.
Throw like here.
So fortunately not facing two here on this shot for Jaylin.
And one more thing that we can't see from here is it's hard to tell whether or not she might be able to get that yellow to rub that red at the edge of the button.
Too much.
Yeah.
7-8. How's the line?
Line's decent. Yeah, hard, yep!
That's starting over. Curl the weight was just a little light.
Just curled, eh?
Yeah.
Pretty good weight.
It's close for a tap. Just over curled the spot. So, no luck for the Cotter team there.
I can't believe how much mine curled. She would get down with somebody I know. I guess that's just how it goes. Yeah, that one there.
I went to Robert's and that's very rough.
Yeah, I thought we were mine too.
I did. 4 minutes, right? Yeah.
Worth it. I thought we were mine.
Me too. She would get down with somebody.
Thanks. 2 months premature and a heart condition. One might say I was born to overcome challenges. I searched for my place in this world, and I found it here. This pebbled ice is where I battle now. I have my sights set on the Olympics, and I will push hard to get there.
Look at you, sitting there eating crisps.
They're chips.
They're crisps, and that's a curling tourney, and you're missing it.
I'm watching it.
You should be there with your kin, feeling the cold of the ice, hearing the roar of the game, and drinking the cold, cold barley nectar.
You mean beer.
Barley nectar. Now get off your duff and live it live.
Curling Canada is home to the most celebrated series of curling championships the world has to offer. You've got to live it live.
Before there was ice, there was our hallway at home. I was always the shy, quiet kid who loved math. But when I saw math come alive in the geometry of the game, I found my passion and my voice. It's a game of precision, a game of inches. It's the equation that now defines who I am.
Welcome back, everyone. Our feature game in the fourth inning break, and while they are, we're gonna quickly update the scores on all the games here in this draw number 11. On sheet one, these two teams both still alive in the playoff picture, but Stephanie Lott and Steve Laycock absolutely need a win. Well, they've got a 4-2 lead as they go into the break against Jocelyn Peterman and Brett Gallant. On sheet two, Jennifer Baxter, Mark Dacey at 3-2 and needing to stay there with a 6-2 lead over the Northwest Territories team of Laura Brown and Nick Hazer. The Prince Edward Island team, Sabrina Smith, Kyle Holland, they had a rough start to the event, but having a better day today, they now have a 7-3 lead against Jesse Kaufman and Brock Virtue, and that's a team that needs to win. Sheet 5, Chelsea Carey and Colin Hodgson trailing Laura Crocker and Jeff Walker 10-1. They've had a bit of a disaster game, give up 5 in the first end and then a steal right away. Janet Murphy, Hugh Murphy at 3-2. They're one of the teams that have to try to stay at 2 losses. They trailed early but picked up a big 4-ender going into the break, and they're tied with Megan St. Amand and Chris Globota. Bob and Jody Smallwood picked up their first win this afternoon. Continue to lead again tonight, 4-2. They're playing Sean and Katie Cottrell on Sheet 7. And on Sheet 8, a much lower scoring game for Rachel Holman and Mark Nichols than the one they had this afternoon. They have a 3-2 lead going into the break against Ashley Quick and Mike Armstrong, and that's another one of those 3-2 teams trying to stay there.
They certainly picked a tough opposition against Holman and Nichols. They've just been solid out there. Anytime they have been in just a little bit of trouble, one of Rachel's usually bailed them out, but they have just been basically mowing over their opposition. They have given up some multiple point ends, but
I think they were the ones that had the, did they not score 5 in the first end in their last game? And that was might have been against the Murphys. And it ended up as an 11-9 final.
Tied up coming home,
that's right.
2-8, but Holman and Nichols have certainly looked really solid.
Hugh Murphy was actually talking to us after
that game and said,
in retrospect, that probably wasn't a sound strategy, spotting them to a 5-point lead.
Same way you've been throwing. Top 8 spin. Top 4.
Well, you certainly have to adjust your mental outlook here when you're looking at the scoreboard, how quickly you can get back into a game, and how quickly you can have a lead disappear on
you.
Two factors that lead into that are the pre-positioned guard and
Lisa
rock
Pearl.
In the house, and that you can't remove a rock from play anywhere until the fourth thrown rock. So it's a set of rules that really works towards keeping rocks in play.
Well, I'm a little strong on that one. Slides to the back 12.
Fine. Pretty quick there.
Chance for John Ebbing to
come
to that stone at the back 4 foot.
Go pretty quick, eh?
Yeah. Hey, good, John.
Okay, let's try and get to the inside.
Brings
of that
right into the full 4 foot, almost biting the button.
Okay.
See from that angle. He's got a corner of that stone under cover.
Just really nice listening to Jim with the constant encouragement and finding something positive out of everything, just staying focused on the shot. As we were talking at the break, what a learning experience for Jay Lynn. And you thought this was probably the first time she's ever worn a microphone and been on camera.
I went to give her the mic and she had no idea how to put it on or anything. So.
I mean, that certainly adds to the butterflies and anxiety. And then you look around and you go, oh my goodness, that's Lisa Weigel I'm playing against.
Still, she did win a provincial championship, so it was obviously came through some pressure situations before.
Enough ice.
Where's ideal?
What a tremendous experience as a young curler.
One thing that might be giving her the bigger trouble in this game, and I don't know, we focused mostly on sheets 4 and 5. We've definitely noticed on these two sheets, I don't know if it's been that way all the way across, but one side tends to be different weight than the other side, and that has given her a little trouble so far in this game. She throws the heavy side, comes up short, then adjusts her weight when they're throwing the other side coming the other direction, and on this end you saw it a little strong.
And when it's one of those games, you're never heavy on your throw on the heavy side.
Okay, let's make this.
But you can certainly sense the momentum really starting to work towards the Weagle Epping team here. They're getting stronger as this game is going on.
One across and just a hair. Well, pretty much nose.
Nice feet everywhere.
Nose.
Okay.
Jim looking to run this back, get the double on the Reds. Said nose. I think he wants it just a hair low. I'm assuming he's throwing the intern. Just a hair low. He'll double the two Reds out of the top of the rings, and the Raystone should at least pop out into the open. This is still on the high side. Might double peel the guards. That's not so bad. Gets it by the guard and jams the one stone.
Lead shot, rock.
Okay. Yeah, I do. How much?
Still very accessible, though.
It's good.
Just over.
Ward?
Not my lunch.
I think it's going to curl.
Yeah.
Our guards still stayed on right there, so we wanted those. Just missed it.
Yeah, it's pretty close, though.
Good try, Dad.
Yeah, he was close all the way down. Well, and that was such a tough shot to actually kill everything, too.
Whoa, whoa.
He got two out. It was really going to be tough to get all three.
Oh, yep.
Hard, John.
John Ebbing makes the hit,
really?
Jams it on that back stone, not enough to get it out, so it's still biting the back 12.
I don't think it's going to cause any concern, though.
I think we want to try and tap, because if we just weld it, he's going to blast it easy.
Yeah.
We try and tap it and just roll underneath a little bit.
Okay.
We want to just get to the inside a little bit. So I'll throw like here, and we're back here. It should curl pretty good.
We saw how hard John was sweeping there to straighten up his fairly strong weight throw there, and he was working hard to keep it as straight as possible. It curled up quite a bit.
Yeah, a couple of them are easy. When you get to throw a hit, it's like no brainer.
Yeah. Good. It's a little tight.
How's the line?
Line's good.
Little tap.
Yeah. Needs to
needs
curl.
Curl.
Yep.
The inside of the stone now.
Hard.
Look at it hook.
Hard.
Wow. That,
that made a huge move. Might have picked.
Oh.
Now that turn definitely does curl more than the other side, but.
No.
That was a big sudden move.
Come on,
throw. What kind of weight do you like? Do you like firm? Just outside.
And the hard part too, you rolled across too much that can nose and even actually get under here a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit. Yep. You saw what mine did.
Just outside middle with firm.
I think she can't afford to do is be on the outside of this. She might jam it and roll away.
If you're throwing firm, yeah.
Okay.
Likely have to be pretty wide on the broom here with this curl to be on that outside.
Yeah, certainly there was a big curl on that last one. Again, not sure it was all natural. Even you heard Jim say that was way out there. And then suddenly on the
pretty good
red stone. Looking for the nose hit to make it go away. Does. Doesn't look like a nose hit would actually get you a point here.
All right, throw like regular.
We're
gonna try and get underneath a little bit, push this one out. I don't think that, throw like reg.
No.
Yeah.
So facing two red, already down 5-2. Lots
She's
of pressure
get
here.
Some roll here.
That's right. Lots of pressure here on Jaylen.
Feeling good.
And I'm not sure what her regular weight is. You could get away with throwing this quieter. You're never going to kill the second stone, so the closer to the back end of it you get, the better. Even if you throw bumper weight to get some finish by that guard. Okay.
Looks like she got nicely out to the broom. A little backwards motion there. It's
backwards motion. Might not help her with the finish. She's got to get to the inside on this. And it's going to hit it on the outside. It will be one red. Tough shot there for Jaylen. She didn't have a lot of air by that. And really, she was going to have to get late finish. And hope she can hit that thin enough to get to the back edge of that red spin in and make sure she got shot that way.
Well, certainly, if she does come tight, then it's a steal of twos.
Yeah.
Now, that is always one of the...
Lisa Wiegel made a great shot. I mean, they talked about rolling under, but by making the nose hit and staying right there, you couldn't just nose hit that and get shot back. Had to get the roll, and it was going to be a real tough shot to get that roll.
I'm just guessing, but I'm thinking that Jim was probably looking for just a little bit less weight on that shot, hoping to catch the curl. And that's always one of the most difficult parts when you're teaching younger curlers as they're developing their games, is getting that weight, those different weights all into their repertoire.
I guess watch the rock. I don't know how much extra to
that middle weight, that differentiating between hack and board, heavy board.
That might curl up.
So you're going to take here, right?
Yeah.
Because his really curled, eh?
Right here.
Remember how much theirs curled?
This is that.
Cut your hand. I was like, okay, this is pretty close.
You got to give me a chance.
Okay.
Yeah, so did I.
Well, the Cotters have been close on so many shots, like that one in the fourth, and that Jim just feathered, touched the guard there. That was a big turnaround shot.
I wonder with this shot call, is Lisa Wiegel just that much more comfortable throwing her out turn? Because they talked about how heavy they know it is on that side, and you know, it's the first rock of the end. You could play the intern if you really don't like the weight on that side.
Intern or out?
Sorry, John.
That's okay. This side might be a pound heavier. Not much, a little bit.
I felt like I threw just a little bit less than the pound.
Should be close.
Yeah. Like, look at the difference.
Line's good.
Weight's good.
Just for weight. It's out there. It's way out there.
Okay, I got it.
It's way out there.
Way out there early on this side shouldn't be as much of a problem if the weight's close. She's got a lot of room by the guard.
Just freeze.
Maybe just a little too much ice on that one.
Outside edge. More.
Where do you think Jess is on here? John Epping with a chance to come down and try to sit on the inside corner of that, and whereas this shot's been a little bit trickier when they were playing the other side of the sheet, they know this side will curl. It's been the weight on this turn that's been giving them a little trouble.
And it certainly goes against the grain of traditional thought. You're up 4 points, and why am I not hitting something out of here? But unable to. The rule does not permit a rock to be removed from play at this stage.
Just going sideways, but that's the reason why, a little lighter than what they had in mind.
All right, draw one down there, kiddo. Kay. Probably want to, if we got good line, we can hook around theirs a little bit. If it starts to move, we'll just corner freeze theirs. Where'd you take on your last one?
I tried for outside gate.
Okay. Light's okay here.
It is.
We're
light
out there a bit. What's that, light?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, let's go.
I don't think you need to worry a ton about trying to make this side curl. Great job on the brush, actually gets that around, tucks a piece around the red, corners the yellow.
Now John's able to remove.
Is there a bug in there?
Yeah, like the back part of it.
Oh, his microphone is.
It's just scratching my back.
Is it? You want to hear? Let's see.
Looking for a different place to put the mic, perhaps?
I'll just tuck my shirt under. Yeah, it's good.
Is that good?
Now, depending on how much space there is between those yells, it didn't look like there's a lot. John might be able to hit this thick enough to get both of them going.
Oh, I think that's what the plan is.
Well, it gets them both moving, but there was a bit of separation there, and the second stone just moves back for second shot. Okay.
Yeah, but behind that tee line and wide open.
Here.
Chance yet for Jim to come around. Try to sit this right at the top of the button now.
Well, it's pretty close.
It's pretty good.
Definitely has tighter line on this one than he did on the last attempt.
Top four.
Yep.
Are we by?
Yeah, you're by. Yep.
I think it was too early to say that. Okay, now you can say he was by.
What a great sweep.
That turn just, you know.
How much, John?
It's not uncommon to see one turn grow more than the other.
How much? Half.
Okay.
It almost seems like the break point's earlier on that side, too. It's not that the other turn doesn't curl. It still has a good 3.5 feet, but it's a little bit more gradual on the other side.
I'm just guessing Jay Lynn, when she was saying the rocks by, wasn't even considering that one in the house. It was just, let's get by that center guard.
That could be, yeah.
Close. Yep, 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 yep.
Comes by that stone at the top of the forefoot and doubles out the two of the back.
And not by much, even with that huge weight, that was really coming over.
Right there.
Okay. He makes us, I think you can see enough of the yellow with that line to bump it out. All you gotta do is beat out that one, then we'll give him two.
Sure.
Okay.
Yep. Okay.
Right?
Yep.
So again, a consideration for Jay Lynn, sort of youth in this game here. Jim taking the time to call his shots and then go back down to throw them. That will certainly probably not be in the case when they're here, you know, in 4 or 5 years back again as BC reps.
Well, maybe. Might be true, might not. That's one thing I'm seeing. Both teams here, and we talked about it earlier, we're seeing both teams taking a look at the house from the home end, or the
make
house
sure
end before they
yellow.
Go to throw the shots.
Yep.
More than we've seen with other teams, and of course they come into this game, one team's at 4-1 and the other at 3-2, so maybe there's something to be said for that.
Okay, hard on that red. Hard on that red.
Go, John.
Shoot. Played too afraid.
Didn't get the weight or the line that he was looking for. Rolls over enough that it's fourth shot. Now we heard John Epping saying,
show me that room.
And I'd question the way he phrased it, said she could see half of that to remove it with back line. She can get to half of it with back line. She can't see half of it with back line.
Okay. Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Oh, your broom is edge of the four.
Okay.
Right?
Yep. Is it a little slow in the middle, do you think?
Yeah. I think you got to go.
Oh, I can barely see it.
Oh, it's hooping in there all day. This.
I should have let you know how big I was. I didn't think
solid
I was that much, but
solid.
I was.
Edge of four with back line?
Yeah, edge of four nice and positive, okay?
I was afraid to be light and then corner for each other and then double.
Yeah.
You got this. Do this.
Oh.
Getting really interesting, just believing how much curl is in this place. That is hard to sort of get over that hurdle when that guard is staring you right in the face.
Well, and there could be two factors that were this
hard.
Is really taking off.
I'm going hard!
All right,
gonna clip the guard. Even if she'd gotten by the guard, she was never getting by the red one at the top of the eight.
She threw the outside draw here, right? Your first one?
Weight was pretty close. So. You look at where it spun to after making that contact on the guard. Your weight was real close.
Could have had then more weight for the broom or...
Well, they probably could have been on it. They knew that was going to curl. And boy, when it decided to go, it went hard. But one of the things that can cause you the trouble, again, we've got one turn curling a little more than the other, and we've talked about this a bit before, about how one player throws in the middle three. Well, the other side of it, in a traditional curling game, you throw one, you're not waiting for six more rocks to be thrown before you throw your second one. And in the case where they're playing two sides and they aren't curling the same, if you throw one on the straight side, one on the curling side, now you throw them in that curling side, and boy, that looks like a lot of ice that you need to take to get by.
Say this mixed doubles discipline plays tricks with your mind.
Weight's good.
Well, in that we're so set with our traditional way of playing.
That six rocks in between is... We've talked about the three rocks in a row. What we haven't talked a lot about is for that first and fifth thrower, you're watching six.
Sorry.
Slides through, doesn't manage to catch any of the backing, so it'll be just a single point for the BC team. Lisa Weigel and John Epping now with a 6-3 lead as they go into the seventh end, and they will have last rock here.
Second one's a little faster.
I think we're going to see a power
play.
Fast?
No, I think they're the same. I can't get my weight down.
No, it's...
And John setting it up for the power play, and they're going to play it on the intern side.
Well, Jaylin isn't missing by much on some tricky ice out there, but can certainly start to play with your confidence after a while.
Jim's wondering about the stones. Jaylin not willing to play in the stones. I think the bigger problem she's had is that they keep mixing
up the
sides
of the sheet.
That one
looks like it needs to go over
here.
Maybe this one too.
I think Jim had said it was a pound heavier, but from some of the shots we've seen, I would say the two sides are probably close to 10 feet different.
Is that good?
She keeps flipping back and forth from one side to the other. Just can't seem to get the weight on either of them.
Yeah, because that red one's supposed to be buried, right?
Yeah, it's supposed to be buried.
I think so, yeah. It's either that one's off or this one's off. That looks good there.
That should be dead buried, but it's not. Yeah, it's got to go a bit this way. It's not dead buried.
This one looks like it needs to go over a hair.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. There you go. I think you're good.
It looks dead center.
Good work. I don't
want
to be like a dick, but.
Hold on a sec. Throw a center guard.
Didn't want it set up properly.
Throw a center guard. Either turn's fine. He'd
expect
this. So staying on the side of ice that threw going away there in the fifth and just through here in the sixth. Said just trying to get that consistency in her draw weight.
Yeah, she plays the same side a few times to give her a chance to gauge the draw weight. Doesn't need to panic about curling a lot. This is the side that curls. She's going to get to split that center line. That's a really good guard, and that should give her the gauge for draw weight.
The spot's going to curl, right? So you got to give here probably.
Okay.
Right there?
She's got that perfectly splitting center.
Yeah, I think your second rock's faster. Because
I think
weight was good there. I think your second one's faster.
Gotta get some curl. Heavy?
Yeah.
Now this is something that we haven't seen yet. When team does throw up that center guard, we haven't seen in the other team ignore it and still loop another one around the center, or pardon me, around the corner.
Nice.
That's certainly a different ploy. Right. They're already up three.
It's not bad. They definitely don't want to play in the middle. They know they're going to peel at as soon as they get a chance.
Top four.
Lisa puts it in perfectly. She did try one of her patented shots, though. I was waiting for a in-person.
Yep. How's the weight?
Weagle specialty.
For Weagle and Epping.
Needs to curl.
It's a bit down.
If they can get the play off the middle and have a chance to bring those two in to score, they could put this game away here in this seventh end. Kind of force the Cotters to commit to the hard steal, and you have a chance to maybe end this game in seven.
Now what do we do?
Are we worried about that?
It won't touch it.
Throw a guard, or do you want, should we
what draw
down
take?
These two?
The one.
I'm waiting for the answer.
Yeah, it's...
Flip a coin.
You're three down with two ends to play. It. Forcing them to one's not a great result. Stealing one's not a great result.
And the secret wish of John over curling and driving it into those reds did not happen.
Throw a center.
Wish might not be a strong enough word for that. Well, if you go whole hog for the steal here, get a steal of one. The power play's been used. It's a lot easier to steal two on the traditional setup of these ends. I think forcing them to one. Four down coming home, I mean, it's not impossible. In fact, we saw two games in the same draw a couple of draws ago where teams had a chance to score four coming home. Didn't work out for either one of them, though.
So the longer you play this game and see the scoreboard
How's
results,
the, line? Curl.
The more you learn that
right
you
center.
Can keep coming back. I think I mentioned yesterday there was a game in our Saskatchewan provincial finals where the game was tied after six, and the one team goes and gets four in the seventh end, and the next thing you know, you look, you go, how is that sheet in an extra end? Well, the other team came back with their four.
Well, we talked about earlier. I was talking to Jeff Stoughton Wednesday night.
Yours in a little better spot.
He was talking about an event held earlier in the season, and a team had scored five in the first end and came right down to the wire to play that game. And we saw it here earlier in the game. It was Rachel Holman and Mark Nichols scored five in the first end and were tied up coming home. Had to score two to win.
Well, we could probably go through the results here from 10 draws and look through the number of five-enders that have not put away games. Like, it doesn't matter what stage of the game it's scored.
Yeah, there's really not much about this game that's designed to let you play real easy defense.
What's he going to do on his last?
Tap? Deal again, tap. Or come around, Bob. You want tap, or come around.
Oh, scoring is
good. Line's good. Yeah. Needs to curl a bit. Needs to curl.
Jim looking to find that center line again.
Yeah.
You got it all the way,
with a straighter turn.
That's
that just about dead buried. There might be a sliver, but
really
just going to peel the guard. Might be able to get both guards here.
Okay, so.
Certainly a lot safer shot this way than.
John. Can't really tap it.
Even looking for the bonus,
so
you heard him say, if it catches the back end,
the
might be able to spin the shooter into the rings.
The intern come around. Whichever you prefer. What's that? Intern, okay. And if you end up splitting it, that's good too, okay?
Okay. The hit comes across, does catch that stone now. Where will the red spin to? Oh. It's going to spin through the 8 foot and right out of play, but you heard John Epic talk about that. They were conscious of it, and one of the reasons why you hear the Cotter team talking about what they were going to play, well, John Epic was talking about it before that shot. He knew what they were going to play. They're going to play the come around on their own stone. If he spins into the corner of the 4 foot or even full eight, this come around's not good enough.
I think so.
Well, yeah, because he's going to pick it up.
We'll be up to
give
up one, yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, and then they can't use a power play.
Yeah, exactly. What if we score three?
Yeah. Yes. Let's try for that.
The turning is really the straight one or the curling one? We played a bunch of interns, maybe?
I played the interns, yeah.
But in a day and a half, we've had more conversations about, I think it's better if the opposition steals. Like, we're just not used to hearing that. But as Lisa had said, then it takes away the power play.
Yeah, they haven't used theirs yet, and they wouldn't have last rock, so wouldn't get that option.
So again, all the quirky nuances of this game. This shot's looking really nice.
Oh,
just
over-curled.
Thought
I think Jim might
there.
Have been afraid she was heavy and needed the rub.
That's good.
He might have been right.
That's good.
One, I think it's a power play. That's fine.
We just didn't want to go. I was scared to get a bye because if we go to the back 12.
So it's going to come up.
Really
and
good shot. That's perfect.
So normal?
Yeah.
We take that much off the rock?
Them, okay. So. Good end.
Yeah.
So not too much, but...
It'll come
okay.
up.
Yeah, nice throw.
Like
normal.
Even if I get one, might as well, right? Sure. They ride some rock.
I think so, Jim. You're going to have a chance to use your power play. And as we said, we saw a draw earlier. Two teams, four down, coming home, and both of them had shots. They were actually, one of them was a very makeable shot, but neither one of them had things work out for them. But you get to throw your last rock with four down. You can't ask for more than that.
It's out there a bit.
Hard for a piece.
Hard for a piece. That's
not what you want to hear. Four up. Well, it was hard enough to get a piece, so it's a steal of one.
Sorry, John.
I think they're happy either way.
Closed within 6-4. And
okay, we need to steal, so no, we won't play the power play.
You don't get the option without last rock. And you know, if you can steal a single point on the other team's power play, you'd think it should be a little
good
bit easier
there,
to steal
John.
Two when you're
good
playing
sweet.
The ends in the middle. Yeah, that goes down in the book of things you never want to hear. We're up four, hard for a piece.
Have a good end. On the way out there.
This is the straight turn too,
yeah,
so she's a little concerned in her voice.
Way out there on the straight turn, not good. So Jim jumps onto the other side right away.
Line's getting better.
A little short,
it's a little heavier on that side too. That's the side where she's been coming up short, and then
okay.
Play the faster side, comes up heavy.
Top four.
A guard there is not the end of the world for them.
Okay. Six, is that okay?
Yep.
So what do you think here?
Especially when you know it hard curl
like
there on the out turn.
Taken there.
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah, if you ever skinny the guard on the out turn, you're
like
actually going to bury
fast.
Behind the one
like
that was just
you
thrown.
Guys threw it a bunch of times, right?
Yeah, but then we haven't played it.
Okay.
Fine. Light's good.
So just regular draw
just
speed.
Just a regular draw there. It's not that zone.
It's
fast.
A lot better than heavy. We got two guards now.
Even though it's an inadvertent shot there, nobody's thrown up a second guard with the option to do so. They have always come into the one in place. I'm kind of curious to see how this one
close
plays
shot.
Out.
Close for line. No, it's okay. We heavy? Make it good. Whoa. Set. It's
good.
A little deep.
Brings that stone into the butt. She would have liked to have it maybe a couple of inches
all
higher.
All right, draw one down there.
It's a pretty good shot. If nothing goes well for you for the rest of the end, that's still a couple of rocks that they're going to have to do something with to have any chance to score four. There's not going to be a lot of room.
Well, and two, with those guards just slightly staggered,
yeah,
no real run back in there either.
Right now.
And the two guards are going away
heavy?
Right away.
Yeah. It's pretty good,
let
though.
Let it work.
So looking to lock one right on the face here. Oops, it's just a few inches. John Epping will look for the double peel with his first stone, or second stone, I guess. Or pardon me, it was the steel
here,
aspect,
I'll get
so this is
one,
first
so it doesn't
stone.
Bounce back.
You might want to let that one bounce back, Jim. Maybe tap that red in behind a little better.
They'll never know.
Thanks, Jim.
So those three all leave.
Nice
all right,
shot,
let's guard this.
Which side?
Let's go this side.
Now Jim gonna have to make a couple of decisions. Certainly you throw a guard with this one.
Take a time.
And he's not sure about that. I'm counting the rocks myself. They're going to take a timeout. The issue that he runs into, needs to steal two here. And those reds aren't at a great angle. He's going to have to tap them at some point in time.
Just wondering if we tap this there. Just try and create a pocket, or if it's too early. Then he's going
to
blast.
He's going to blast when you do it anyway, but you've either got to do it on this
maybe
one or the next one.
Throw one more guard.
Yeah, even if like you tapped it like just
tapped it just to hide the hair high side, yeah.
Yeah. Like just like
one, keep going to one.
Because then he'll get
with it. Right here.
Right?
Yep. So he'll get one of them out pretty easy.
He might get them both if you don't
stay.
Top to a pocket.
And then we'd have. Okay.
Just right now they're sharp.
Okay,
right?
Yeah. So let's throw one more guard and then we'll play that.
Okay.
Shade more.
So Jim's got him counted up the same way I do. You're still hoping for, you're going to need some kind of a miss later on, but if you can set up some jams, you might get a little bit of help. Throw the guard first, hope something goes wrong on that.
Mine's good. If anything, it needs to curl. It needs to curl.
Needs to curl? It'll get there.
Just clean.
It'll get there.
Like same turn, John?
Gets just about dead split on the center line.
Let's go.
You take a timeout, take the time to talk about it and decide exactly how you want to play these last three. You play the guard.
You want to tap it?
Takes John Epping all of about 3 seconds to put the broom down to peel it.
That's right. It's just like your football huddle where you've called out your next five plays.
On this side frozen. Might not be bad. So we'll let you know the weight.
Good.
He's got to deal with the rocks and the rings now. There's a couple of different ways he could do it.
Here and roll our shooter here.
Yeah. Or no. Just looking at there, if he rolls the shooter over John, probably hits the
open
and freeze on it again.
All these are gone, right?
Yeah.
So I'm wondering if we nick it and then roll over to here.
Yeah, I like that.
I'm wondering if that's better.
Though.
Yeah. And then if it curls up, we play this. Create a little pocket. It's fine too, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's both there.
Okay.
So if it's hanging out, we want to just nick it. If it starts to curl, like half a rock, catch about a half right onto there, okay?
Okay.
I'll let you know the weight.
So the thought process here for the Connors, if you can roll over, and of course, knowing that Epping and Wiggler are into elimination mode, they might have to make a play on the open stone. If they choose to ignore the open stone and play towards the stone in the middle, you might have a chance to sit three. There's two ways to steal two. You've either got to sit three and hope for a rollout, or try to get two rocks frozen in that button area. can make this shot well, at least force John Ebbing into a decision.
Back eight.
He's trying to tackle.
Back four.
Clean. Just clean. Unless
wait the turnaround shot in his hand.
Back
was four. The double peel there by John when
Jalen's
shot came up.
Hard.
Short.
Hard all the way.
So just about like how he's drawn it out.
A little bit later had in mind, but it does the same thing. I expect you'll see John smash this from the outside.
That?
How much?
Hope that yellow, even if it doesn't go all the way out of the rings, it should eliminate the backing from behind it, and it'll be just an open hit for Lisa Weigel.
Well, even if he nose hits, rolls in front,
there's no chance he's throwing this quiet enough to curl across the face.
No, but that takes away that.
Well, we want to hit our right on the nose. Create a pocket.
Yep.
Oh, good shot.
Or he could do
and
that.
And he makes the double, and that'll eliminate all discussion about what to play next. That's the game.
Thanks, Lisa. Good luck.
Lisa Weigel, John Epping pick up the victory, and they will move to, that puts them at 5-1. Jim Cotter and his daughter, Jalen, now dropped to 3-3, and they're amongst those teams looking for a little bit of help. We're going to turn our attention quickly over to sheet one. Eighth end action underway. Two more teams here that Jocelyn Peterman, Brett Gallant, trying to stay up at the top of their pool. Stephanie Lawton and Steve Laycock trying to keep themselves alive. They're 2-3 coming in. Tied up coming home. It's Glanton Peterman with last rock. Just 3 stones left to come. Or pardon me, it's Laycock and Lawton with last rock. Four stones left to come. And they've got the guard off the center line. Brett Gallant trying to play the come around. He's got room by the guard. Looks like this is finishing nicely. How deep can they get it? Gets full 12. Not sure what the clock situation is like, but both Stephanie and Steve were signaling for the timeout before this yellow even came to rest, so they might be a little tight.
Happy to have that red catcher over on the side. Leave some options open for Stephanie's last shot.
We're not directly in behind this sheet. The way they're calling is must be able to see a piece of that stone. Boy, if they get that back another foot and a half, 2 feet, I think it's dead buried.
Actually, Stephanie signaling. Looked like she was even thinking of the run back there, but sticking with her initial call for the intern pick.
Steve got down to the hack in and now looking for just a little bit more right. Ice, so maybe he can't see as much as he thought. He's going to bring the weight down a bit. Okay. Definitely not big weight on this, just maybe a heavy board.
This is curling hard off the line.
Yeah, he's on the guard.
That was just barely board weight.
Yeah. Well, he definitely took more ice when he got to the hack, so I'm thinking when he got down there, he couldn't see as much as he thought he could. Getting rid of the guard's not a bad result. He still has, like you said, that biter in the 12-foot.
That's true. I mean, it's certainly not the worst result, but...
Well, and you know the button's going to be available, too. You can't draw to the button when you've got a rock in the 8-foot. You'd just be an open hit, so they're going to try to tap that straight back. Their time might be a little tight as well. They've already got the shot decided. Still going to call the timeout. I think they decided they're playing the tap. Just the ice they're, or pardon me, the ice they're trying to determine. We're guessing a bit. The only thing I saw them tap was to, or indicate was that they were going to play the tap. Certainly with that ice, that looks like that would be the call.
Well, not desperate for
there you see the clocks.
Time.
Brett made sure that Jocelyn had a good look at where they wanted the broom, and then he makes his way down to the other end. He's going to sweep this rock. You can afford to be just a hair offline on the tap back, as long as you leave it a good half under the raised stone.
So no wonder why Steve's shot really curled over. There's a big curl here on this intern side.
Really curling and really coming down for Wade too. She's not gonna tap this very far.
But far enough.
Gets probably 3/4, 4 foot.
Stephanie going to have to decide. She wants the nose hit double or draw this full four.
Well, it's a short double. They're only 2 feet apart. They're gonna use their second timeout. They were a little tight for time too. Thought she indicated they might be looking at the draw. I wonder, with both Brett's and Jocelyn's looking like they had lots of weight and having trouble getting to the 8 foot, it's maybe getting a little heavy down this middle path.
And Stephanie is such a good hitter.
And she hits so well, yeah. And again, there's only 2 feet between those two rocks. It's not like it's the toughest double you've ever seen. Now with Steve on the side of the zone, it looks like they're lining up for the intern draw. This is going to have to go for
looks
weight.
Looks like it's coming down hard on the...
Yeah, and really curling towards the yellows too. And looks like this is going to come up just a little bit short. It's going to be a steal, and Brett Gallant and Jocelyn Peterman move to
5-1.
Steve Laycock and Stephanie Lawton fall to 2-4, and that's probably mathematically out of it. Just one game left in play now, and it's one of those games we talked about. This can happen. We were even looking at whether or not it was possible in our own for a bit. Four down coming home. And they're going to get to throw last rock. And there might be a triple available on the yellows. It's a run back triple, I think. That could score them four. He's going to give it a go anyway. This is going to have to curl, and that's not likely to happen with that kind of weight. One of these times I want to see somebody get close enough to that to see whether or not the shot's even possible.
So that was the last game.
Just runs it by everything. So Bob and Jody Smallwood will pick up the victory there. And we'll do a quick recap of all the games here in this draw number 11. You saw the tail end there, the last couple of shots. Jocelyn Peterman and Brett Gallant on sheet one steal the victory over Stephanie Lawton and Steve Laycock. Jennifer Baxter and Mark Dacey staying at two losses. They pick up the 7-4 victory over Laura Brown and Nick Kayser. Sabrina Smith and Kyle Holland, Team Prince Edward Island, with an 8-7 victory over Jesse Kaufman and Brock Virtue. That drops them to, I believe it's 3-3. I've got it written down here as 2-3 here, but we're missing a game somewhere. Lisa Weigel and John Epping, our feature game, the 6-4 victory over Jalen and Jim Cotter, and that drops the Cotters to 3-3. Laura Crocker and Jeff Walker move to a perfect 6-0 with a 10-1 victory over Chelsea Carey and Colin Hodgson, and that drops them to 4 losses. Janet Murphy and Hugh Murphy staying at 2 losses. They pick up the 8-7 victory with 3 points in the 8th end over Megan St. Amand and Chris Klobota. Bob and Jody Smallwood, you saw the last shot there. They were 4 up coming home. It's only a single, and They pick up the 7-4 victory over Sean and Katie Cottrell. And on sheet 8, Rachel Holman and Mark Nichols also staying perfect at 6-0 with a 10-7 victory over Ashley Quick and Mike Armstrong.
That will drop Mike and Ashley to 3-3, and Mark and Rachel picked up 5 in the 8th end for that 10-7 win.
Their second 5-ender of the day. So we will be back at 9 o'clock. Draw 12, we will feature Joanne Courtney and Reed Carruthers against Team Saskatchewan. Dustin Kaltoff and Marlies Kasner. We want everyone to join us then. Thank you for being with us all day and all day yesterday. And we've looked like we could have a long day again tomorrow. Playoffs start tomorrow night. We'll try to keep you up to date on how things are looking as the draw goes through tonight. We'll see you again in about 45 minutes.
Good night.